Welcome back to Tightwad Workshop. So a few days ago, I paid $2 for this tool that hardly anybody uses anymore, the Stanley Model 135A Yankee Screwdriver. Before electric screwdriver drills like this became commonplace, this was your go-to tool if you needed to drive in a whole bunch of screws. It has a couple of different modes of operation. If you move this switch to this position, it works as a ratchet screwdriver to drive your screws in. Moving the switch the other way gives you a ratchet in the other direction. But unscrewing this collar really makes the magic happen. Now we have a screwdriver that'll make two full turns every time you push the plunger. As you might expect, that lets you drive your screws in much faster. Now when they were new, these would have been supplied with three different screwdriver bits, but unfortunately mine only has one. And I mostly use Phillips screws these days. So let's see if we can make a new bit for our screwdriver that will work with our Phillips screws. Now the simplest way to do that would be to take one of these bits and turn down this end on the lathe to match our factory bit. But as you probably know, here at Tightwad Workshop, we prefer to do things the hard way. I'll start by cutting a half coil off the spring. Now we can light this blowtorch, then use it to light the forge. I'll use the anvil's hardy hole to do the rough straightening. Now we can finish the straightening with our hammer. Next, I need to turn the workpiece around to straighten the other end. Coil springs are made from high carbon steel, which can be hardened and softened by heat treating. So by cooling it slowly, we'll anneal the metal, which will make it softer and easier to shape in the next steps. Once the steel is cooled, I'll put it into the lathe chuck to shape our screwdriver point. I'll make the new point about the same length as our factory point. I'm going to use this high-speed steel cutting tool to cut out the shape. I'm using a deep cut and slow rotation and feed rates for the roughing cuts. The finishing pass is done with a much faster lathe RPM to give a smooth surface. If I've done this right, the new bit should fit snugly into our screwdriver's chuck. So now that we've cut the shank, we can rough out the screwdriver's tip. I'm doing this in two stages because otherwise the unsupported metal will get too whippy and it'll cause chatter against the cutting tool. Now we can use a parting tool to cut our blank from the stock. I'm going to take a shortcut here and bevel the tip of our new screwdriver bit on this bench grinder. I'll use this screwdriver to mark the correct angle on the tool rest, then slowly grind in the bevel. Now we can take our blank to the milling machine and fit it into this four-sided collet block. I'm using this small machinist square to set the correct amount of stick out for the blank. Now we can start up the mill and cut our first flute. For the other flutes, we just need to turn our collet block 90 degrees and make the same cut. Once you've set up your milling machine to do this, you can easily make as many screwdriver bits as you need. You can also use this setup to recut the points on worn out screwdrivers. That looks pretty good, but I'll need to use a small file to remove these burrs before we go on to the next step. Our next steps are done using the vise and some files. We need to cut these two notches into our new screwdriver bit. We'll start with this drive notch at the end. This is easy to do with a few strokes from our flat file. It's a good idea to test the fit before you file too deep. That looks good, so now we need to file the retainer notch that holds the bit into the chuck. Once again, I'll use our factory bit to mark the notch's location. Then I'll cut the notch with a triangular file. That looks about right, so let's give it a test. Our new bit works fine, but the metal is still soft and it'll wear out quickly. So our final step is to heat treat the point to harden it. I'll start by heating the point to a bright orange heat, then rapidly quenching it in water. That'll leave the point very hard, but it'll also be brittle and likely to crack while we're using it. Now I'll refer to my blacksmithing textbook to find out how I need to temper the steel. According to this table, screwdrivers need to be tempered to a blue colour, so I'll use some sandpaper to clean the metal back to a shiny colour first. Now we can relight the blowtorch to temper the steel. Start heating slowly from the tip and watch for the colour band on the metal surface. You can see the blue band moving downwards now. I think I might have overcooked this one, but we'll see how it performs with use. Okay, let's give it a test. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.
Tightwad Workshop is filmed in front of a live studio audience.